Jupiter's unusual icy moon Europa may be one of the best spots in the solar system to check for signs of alien life. But first we have to get there. NASA's Europa Clipper spacecraft will get a boost in the right direction from a SpaceX Falcon Heavy, one of the most powerful rockets ever built. It's been a great few months for Elon Musk and SpaceX, with another Starship launch just around the corner. The company's been landing some insanely lucrative deals with NASA. In fact, NASA and SpaceX have finalized a contract that will see SpaceX's Falcon Heavy launch and deliver the Europa Clipper spacecraft to Jupiter's icy moon. The moon Europa is strongly believed to have conditions suitable for supporting life. Could this mission discover the first signs of alien life on another world? The launch is expected to take place sometime in October of 2024 from the Kennedy Space Center Complex 39A. The contract will reportedly cost NASA $178 million, which is quite the bargain compared to the $2.1 billion it would have cost to launch the mission using NASA's Space Launch System rocket, or SLS. It was almost inevitable that SpaceX was going to win this contract. Congress passed a bill in December 2020, giving NASA the freedom to select any commercial space vehicle of their choice, as an alternative launch for the mission. Initially, spending bills by Congress for NASA were strictly reserved for the Europa Clipper to launch through the SLS. But because of SLS's high prices, NASA requested the flexibility to work with a commercial launch vehicle. So as soon as the bill was passed, NASA directed the Europa Clipper project to cease all plans to launch the spacecraft through the SLS and instead focus on a launch with a commercial company. NASA would then go on to select SpaceX's Falcon Heavy, because they were satisfied that it met all the technical requirements to carry out the mission. One of the reasons why they selected SpaceX is because they placed the Europa Clipper in Category 3 for launch services. This means that the Europa Clippers should be carried on a commercial vehicle that has performed at least 3 successful launches. This put the Falcon Heavy miles above competing commercial rockets. You see, SpaceX's Falcon Heavy was successfully flown 3 times, despite not being launched since 2019. Other competing vehicles such as United Launch Alliance's Vulcan Centaur and Blue Origin's New Glenn haven't even had their first launches. Yet the Falcon Heavy is also more efficient in terms of payload delivery. Compared to the other rockets, the Falcon Heavy is able to deliver 63,800 kilograms to Earth's lower orbit, while the Vulcan Centaur can deliver 27,200 kilograms, and lastly, the New Glenn can deliver 14,000 kilograms. And in terms of cost per launch, the New Glenn would reportedly cost NASA about $2 billion to launch with them, and the Vulcan Centaur would cost them about $200 million. So it's a no-brainer why NASA went with SpaceX. It's cheaper, more proven, and far more efficient. The only issue with selecting the Falcon Heavy is that it's slightly slower than NASA's SLS. With the SLS, the Europa Clipper would have arrived at Jupiter's moon in less than 3 years, but with Falcon Heavy, it should arrive at Europa in about 5.5 years after it launches. Lately, the United States government has been putting a lot of faith in SpaceX. The Europa Clipper contract is one of several future Falcon Heavy missions with NASA. The Department of Defense and private commercial clients in February, for example, NASA awarded SpaceX with contracts to launch the first 2 modules of the Lunar Gateway, and then in April they awarded them with the contract to launch the Griffin lunar lander that will be tasked with carrying a NASA lunar rover to the moon. If the launch of the Europa Clipper takes place in October of 2024 as planned, it is expected to reach Jupiter's orbit by April of 2030. The probe will then be used to investigate several distinct features of the planet, as well as analyze if it is capable of supporting life. It will capture high-resolution images of Europa's surface to determine the composition and search for signs of ongoing geological activity. It will also measure the thickness of the moon's icy shell, measure the salinity and depth of the moon's oceans, and search for subsurface lakes. But why is the Europa mission specifically so important to NASA scientists? Well, for life in the universe to thrive, it requires 3 things: elements like carbon that create complex molecules, called organics, a liquid solvent like water, and an energy source, and Europa has all 3 of these things in abundance. Also, this Jupiter moon looks pretty much the same as ours, but it is covered with an ice shell that is roughly 12 miles thick, so hypothetically speaking, if we replaced our moon with Europa, it would seem the same size in the sky. But much brighter, so much brighter. In fact, with a surface made entirely of ice, this moon would reflect nearly 5.5 times The sunlight that our moon does in terms of position, Europa orbits Jupiter, at around 417,000 miles from the planet, and it also orbits the Sun, around 500 million miles away. Light from the Sun usually takes about 45 minutes to reach Europa, because of this massive distance. The light hitting Europa is about 25 times fainter than the light that hits our moon and Earth, so how does Europa get a sustainable energy source? Well, beneath the subsurface ice, there lies a liquid salt water ocean that is estimated to be about 100 miles deep, with more than twice the amount of water that Earth's combined. Oceans have. While no sunlight reaches Europa's oceans, it is believed that the waters are heated slightly due to vents on the ocean floor that release heat from the moon's core, as such scientists strongly believe that life could be found teeming in some of these deep dark events. After all, we have some similar creatures at the bottom of our seas. Jupiter could also be providing the moon with another source of energy. You see, the planet's magnetic field traps high-energy particles from the Sun, and accelerates them into Europa's ice, which creates molecules important for life like hydrogen, ammonia and methane. Once launched in 2024, the Europa Clipper probe is expected to arrive by 2030, marking it as the first dedicated mission to explore a world with a global ocean besides Earth. By finding out whether Europa has the ideal conditions for life, we'll be able to better understand the chances of finding life on other ocean worlds, in our solar system and the worlds beyond. Now the question is, how will the Europa Clipper collect information? First of all, it will orbit Jupiter instead of Europa directly, so that it can spend time outside the moon's intense radiation field. In fact, NASA's scientists plan to have the spacecraft occasionally dive through Jupiter's radiation, fly by Europa for data collection, and then exit these intense fields. This strategy will allow Europa Clipper to study the moon for several years, rather than days or months. The spacecraft is also constructed with a wide range of science instruments to scan Europa from above and directly sample the moon's atmosphere. A radar instrument will map Europa's ice, while a magnetometer will be used to determine the depth and salinity of the ocean. There will be infrared and color cameras that will allow the probe to analyze the surface in color and search for hot spots where the ocean could be seeping up through the ice shell. NASA has further equipped the probe with spectrometers to assess the composition of the surface and search for any plumes that might be pushing water vapor into space. The Europa Clipper will also be used to search for locations where future space missions might be able to land. One mission under consideration by NASA would be to spend a month on Europa's surface, feeding samples into instruments designed to detect organic materials. Presently, NASA relies on ground-based telescopes to study Europa's surface. That's how they were able to determine that Europa is covered in ice. Through this, they also discovered that beneath the ice crust is an ocean of liquid water or slushy ice. Europa's massive ocean is widely considered the most logical place for life beyond Earth. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching, and goodbye.